Good day friends, welcome to Analyzer Instrument YouTube channel. Many of you might saw a previous video about how to calibrate Ametek 933 analyzer using Ametek 933 configurator software. If you haven't seen this video, it will be in our description and the link will be in our first comment also. You can able to check the video. And one of our YouTube subscriber friend requested us if we could able to show them how to adjust the analog output in Ametek 933 analyzer. The measuring component will be H2S. So we had made this trailer made me too as per the our friend request. So if you like to do some video about some analyzer function or how to calibrate, kindly comment below in our YouTube channel so we could able to make a video for as per your request. And I'll be posting this presentation in our website also. If you like to download for your reference, it will be in our website. And I'll be mentioning a link in our description as well as in our first comment. Kindly go through it. And before getting into the video, how to adjust the analog output analyzer, here is a general introduction about the analog output. So here we will see. The analog output is used to transmit the process information from our analyzer to DCS. So there are two types of analog output which we are using here. So most in case we will be using 4 to 20 milliamps, and some cases we will be using 0 to 10 voltage DC. So for example, if you want to look into this 4 to 20 milliamps, here is the example. And if your analog means sorry if your analyzer range is 10 to 1000 ppm, so the 4 milliamps will be 10 ppm, it is the low range value it is, and 20 milliamps will be 1000 ppm, it will be the upper range value. Considering this, we can able to adjust the analog output in our analyzer. And when we look into this H2S and specifically H2S analyzer, we do have 1 volt to 5 volt DC. So in this range, 1 volt will be our 10 ppm and 5 volt DC will be our 1000 ppm. It will be as a upper range value, means high range value. Before adjusting the analog output, we will be looking how the analog output board looks like. And the analog board is located in the lower compartment of the analyzer. As you are much known about the analyzer, it has two compartments and it will be located in the lower compartment of the analyzer. This is how the analog board looks like. And here we can able to see J109 is a we have four isolated 4 to 20 milliamps self powered or loop powered. Either we can able to use a self or loop power as per our requirement. And we do have J108 terminal. This one is a four non isolated voltage DC, 1 to 5 voltage we can able to see. So here we can able to see J109. First two terminals, I1A and I1B. Will be I stands for our current, means I is for current and V is for voltage obviously, and I1A and I1B two terminals will be specifically for only H2S, and 2, 3 and 4, 5 and 6 will be our optional output if whether we have to configure 4 to 20 milliamps for methyl mercaptans and carbonyl sulfide. COS is a carbonyl sulfide. Either you want to configure, means we can able to configure. And I4A and I4B means the terminal 7 and 8 will be for the optional display. As you all must know, the analyzer 933 Ametek does not have a display for this one. So we have to configure the external display transmitter for configure, means if you want to look into the reading. If you want to look the reading, means we have to configure the external display, which will be applicable for the voltage DC also. The terminal 1 and 2 will be H2S, 3, 4, 5, 6 will be optional for methyl mercaptans and carbonyl sulfide, and 7 and 8 will be for our display. Before adjusting the analog output, connect the serial cable between your laptop or computer to the analyzer communication port and open 933 configurator software. Once you open the software, go to edit and device properties. So this is how the general tabs looks like when you open the device properties. Go to setup tab and press output. Once you open output tab, the screen will appear. So the isolated self-powered current output in 4 to 20 milliamps, here we can able to see. So here we have set the low scale as 0 and the high scale as 10 ppm. So the low scale will be 4 milliamps, 0 will be the 4 milliamps, and span will be the upper range value, high scale, it is 20 milliamps. As well as for voltage output, so voltage output 0 will be 1 voltage DC and span will be 5 voltage DC. Before adjusting the analog output, if you do have any doubts, kindly verify with the vendor. And we need to connect the multimeter to the terminals so we can able to adjust the analog, we can able to see the analog output. And connect the multimeter as shown in this figure. The first two terminal in J109 will be for H2S, as well as first two terminal will be for H2S in J108 in voltage DC. Don't interchange positive and negative terminals and connect the multimeter as shown in this figure for verification. Now we need to stimulate the analog output and verify with the multimeter as well as in the DCS. Now we can able to see the zero cal. In this zero cal, once you press the zero cal, it will be showing 4 milliamps in our multimeter, and in DCS it will be reading 0. As we can able to see, the low scale of the analyzer is 0 ppm and high scale is 10 ppm. So once you press the zero cal, it will be showing 4 milliamps in our multimeter and 0 ppm in our DCS. Next is the mid scale. Once you press the mid scale, our DCS will be reading 5 ppm and our multimeter will be reading 12 milliamps. We can able to verify this one. And the last is span cal. The span cal, once you press the span cal, the output will be in the full scale span. The DCS will reading 10 ppm, as well as our multimeter will be showing 20 milliamps. It will be respective to this voltage also, voltage output also. So according to this one, we can able to adjust our 4 to 20 milliamps here. In analog output, we can able to adjust. If we do have any drift in the output, analog output, we can able to adjust it from the here. Once you adjust everything, don't forget to press normal. Once you press normal, the analyzer will be going back to this normal position. After completing the procedure, now you press the OK button and the setup screen will appear. Once you press apply, it will be asking for either to save an EPROM. Press EPROM to save. These are the references which I used to make this video.